Yeah. Remember the European Championship final where they beat Germany in Portugal.
Oh, that is a fantastic start.
Expect the unexpected, as we said before. Modrić is oozing with quality.
One, all.
It's his first match. As a seed, he had a bye. Gian Geraldo beat Ibrahim Adio in the round of 32. Brilliant rally. I should say the round of 48 because of the buys.
There's an attempt for a chop block. Unfortunately.
3-2.
Charles really trying to rip that one straight from the get-go.
Yeah, there's much more underspin in the serve than he thought. And he had to probably make a bit more loopy spin.
Just wait for it a tad longer. Now that is the forehand, which has helped him rise to top 10 world level. Modrić.
Yeah, and if I can see that replay again after some time. The shift of the body weight to me is so critical for you to execute power in your forehand spins, right? See that? And it comes on so fast.
Puts it away. Like clothes in a drawer. Makes nothing of it. Just another chore for Charles Morrigard, but he enjoys being out here, doesn't he? Really does. Oh, these were the rallies that we saw in the European Championships between these two. He was disappointed with the European Top 16, Morrigard, which occurred last weekend. He lost to Liam Pitchford, who is an amazing player, but still. He wanted to win it, the Swede. But Jorgic won it. Back to back, won it again. And he was beaten, Jorgic here, by a fellow Swede, Jon Persson.
Well, Geraldo is really roaring right now, just like the tattoo on his left bicep. I think it's a tiger. And that probably inspires him to roar the way he is right now.
There's some matches looking at this draw that I know a lot of people would love to see. Tomokazu Harumoto against Truls Morrigard is one of them. Can you imagine the scenes of that game?
6-8.
We've seen Liang Jingquin versus Lin Goyuen a few times. We've got Christian Carlsen still in, and we've got Benc Majoros from Hungary. There is the former world champion, Jorgen Persson. Lovely man, incredible player, obviously. And a fantastic coach for Trolls. Seems like their personalities complement each other very well.
Yeah. And that was a very different serve I've not seen so far.
The forehand topspin serve from the forehand side.
Yeah.
That's Liu Goliang inspired, that serve. Unreal! Just as though you thought Yao Geraldo's backhand would be a winner, Morrigard goes down the line. Clever clog play. Look at this. The awareness there really won him that point. Phenomenal.
That was a very brave attempt and serve from Geraldo. Long on the backhand side, knowing that there could be a spin, top spin out there, but legged it.
The youth are taking over here in Goa. Cho Dae Sung versus Lin Shidong, Uda versus Lin Winru, and the winner of this plays Felix Lebrun of France. The only young player really at the bottom half of this draw is Tomokazu Aramoto.
Absolutely fantastic.
Playing Jang Woo-jin of Korea. Some mouth-watering play. Drop shot and flick.
Beautiful. Just love this sort of table tennis. Bring it short near the net and then punch it deep.
Oh my goodness. Is that coming down? Nearly. Lost sight of the ball. They're here. Flew up. Morigard really does bait the opponent in many ways. Interesting receive from Morigard.
Yeah, very clever receive actually.
If it hadn't hit the net, it would have been interesting to see what had happened. Goes for the really long aggressive dig, and I like that, because some players just float out a push. The top players try to really give it some oomph, put pressure on with the push.
And you know, at the highest level, it's not easy to be actually doing all these and being consistent, because your opponent is equally ready for you and to be able to absorb these kind of weird stuff that they do. So I just feel it's super brave at that level to be executing it.
Yeah. Trying to open up the body to go down the line. I don't know if that was Morigard saying to Jorgen Persson, what am I doing, or what was the spin on Uraldo's backhand, but still, 5-2. Good pressure. For the first time in a long time, Yao Giraldo looking like he might get a game off Morigard. Top spin shovel, coming round the side, but coming up the ball slightly, made the Portuguese player misread. I can see you just getting on the edge of your seat, seeing if that was about to land the chop block.
Yeah, he attempted that once in the previous game and he missed it.
Wow. There was a flatness to it, but also a spinniness. It was a brilliant shot from Trolls. Yeah. The contact was great there. He's got a unique grip, actually, Morigard, hasn't he? Used to call it the hammer grip, but he's developed it a little bit. He only used to really block and punch with the backhand, but now he can spin because he's just changed the grip slightly.
Yeah, but and just to explain the change in the grip further, the thumb is slightly upwards rather than the traditional, you know, shake hand where it slips on the left and down side.
Yeah. When you play your backhands, you're advised to put the thumb up a little bit and press down slightly actually on the rubber with your thumb when you play a backhand. When you play a forehand, you're supposed to put pressure on your forefinger and relax your thumb to create an automatically more closed bat angle.
And if you're a table tennis player watching, you would understand the importance of the pressure the thumb and the forefinger plays.
The fingers are the most important thing in table tennis. People say the footwork, but I think the fingers comes first. Morigard may force the Giraldo timeout here. Looks over to the Portuguese player to see if he does, and he does.
Yeah, and breaking momentum is so critical, especially at this stage. And strategy thought perfectly well by Giraldo. He proved to himself that he's a good thinker. Seems like he actually planned that all the time out. Yeah,
long serve, surprise factor, get in first. Well, there was no net needed there. That was a shot that could make the fangirls blush. Brilliant from Geraldo. And let me tell you, Morrigard's earning himself a few Asian fangirls.
There was a lull, and then Sweden is now back at the top of the world table tennis.
Since the brink of the millennium, we haven't really seen a world or Olympic medalist from Sweden.
Versus the late, early 90s were dominated by the likes of Persson and obviously Wallner.
Of course. The European Championships will be in Oslo, Sweden this year, so the Swedes are looking to get a gold there.
This is killer.
It's a whirlwind, isn't it? It's an army forehand. Massive stroke.
Love that chop block. It finally lands on the third attempt for the Swede.
It does. There was not much spin coming off that one, and Geraldo blasted it off the end. I think he thought that there was. He's mixing things up, Morrigard, isn't he? Aye, the Swedish boxer tricks that time. Couldn't pull the rabbit out of the hat. He went for the round the net, didn't he? The audacious Truls Morrigard. It was actually a lovely side-swiping, fanning forehand from Geraldo to get Morrigard out wide on that angle.
Yeah, and it needs so much belief in yourself to be playing that wide with that sort of an angle.
Oh, it catches the back edge.
Where did that come from?
I've got to correct myself because I said there was no Olympic or World Championship medalist since the like of Waldner, but I meant to say Olympic. Because, of course, Truls, world finalist 2021, and Falk in Budapest, finalist as well.
Yeah.
Been no Olympic medalist from Sweden since the likes of the previous generations.
It's just lovely to see Morrigard showing his dominance in this third game, leading 8-2.
9-2.
With no answers from Geraldo. That is berserk. The Indian fans, I'm sure, super delighted to have these top players play in front of them in Goa here.
Well, and that is the epitome of Morrigard as a player as well.
That's more like in a desperation, you know, you come and slap.
Lovely block down the line there. The table awareness of the Swede is very, very good.
Solly, come on.
1-2.
The table manners can be questioned. We've seen a couple of racket throws and whatnot, but come on, we're human. You're allowed to show some frustration. He's only ever going to be frustrated at himself, Morrigard, right?
But all in the rules of the game.
Exactly. Never seen him get a red, to be fair.
4-1.
Yeah, sheer dominance from the Swede here.
Lovely forehand cross court from the Swedish dream. Another man in the conversation for Durban, Truls Morrigard. Be interesting to see him versus the Liang Jingquin rematch. Has he beat him last time he played? Yeah, he's going from strength to strength. The depth on the table, the lowness to the net, the ability to keep it low over the net after Giraldo's wide shot makes Cho's a hard player to play. He's not a clean player. And what I mean by that is some players are giving you balls that feel nice to play. Morrigard never gives you that.
Yeah, and this is the second match in consecutive that we've been witnessing.
Oh, it was also Voldner-esque, but that was a smash that I would have missed. Jules.
I hope he gets over this horror quickly and leaves it behind.
Oh, Jules.
Sure, he did.
We all miss him, come on. He was disgusted with that.
I love how mentally stable, focused Trolls is at this point, despite missing that blunder.
Yeah.
He's not phased. And produces top table tennis immediately after that.
Trolls is one of them few players that will actually chop block a serve straight away. Some players only do it against third ball, fourth ball, whatever. He does it straight off the serve. Comes across it. There we go, early on again. Is it coming back? It is. Snake. Way, Morrigard entertaining this crowd. But if you're just tuning in, it's not an exhibition. It's a live round of 32 match. Morrigard's saying, what? It touched Giraldo, are you sure? How could that be side, umpire?
Giraldo says, I think I heard.
10-4.
Oh, go on then, they're replaying. Look at this. I think Troll set him up. Lovely around the net. Somehow, Troll's got back to ball. Did it hit the edge? Oh, Giraldo's setting Troll's up for around the net now. This is good to see.
Yeah, they're enjoying now.
Exhibition, hello. It's the last match of the day here. Oh, the chop block smash doesn't come down, but a nice moment of sportsmanship.